interested in it. I started actually during the election, before Trump came. And they all were sick of Trump at that point. They didn't want to publish anything. I mean, I had my agent go around, all New York, nobody wants to publish it. They all wanted me to do something about Hillary, because everybody's like, I'm going to win. And I said, okay, I'll try that. But, you know, to be honest with you, I couldn't get into it. I thought I was going to, but at the same time, I had a nagging feeling. And I just didn't come up with anything. So when Trump won, I still was trying to get the get published, but I took a long trip during the holidays down to Savannah. I drove to Savannah. I had a 9-hour trip down and a 9-hour trip back. And I started thinking about a suggestion a friend gave about a political agency. And I just let it flow. You know, you just take the time to think and measure where does your mind go. And I put my hands on, I'm pretty, I was driving, I just put my hands on the course. And I just kept going A and blah, and A and blah. And I wrote the whole thing down the top. I had the whole word to know. And all I did was sketch it out in like 4 hours. And I had a lot. I let go. I stopped sitting there thinking, I have this other plan. I went with the left side of it. That's the hardest thing for me. I don't know about you guys, but it's just letting go. There's a lot of support on the side on it. So anyway, I don't even remember what the initial question was. But go ahead.
Neither do
I. I want to know about the movie. You seem to animate the
for the MA. You know what? I'm old school. Because when I went to CalArts, we were still using paper and flipping. So I'm still drawing.
Quiet down.
Now, you know, I've always liked paper. I know I could save a lot of time on a city, you know, and I just like paper. I've gone back. My earlier work, if you're familiar with my print work, I used brush ink. Now I'm doing crystal pencils, because I was doing that live sketching fast. And now the watercolors, so I'm basically doing it all on paper. I was doing flash at first, and flash was it's a nightmare. It's counterintuitive to anyone that's done animation. It's this is one of those things. And like I said, it's a light image. It's easy to share, and when they're on a loop, they work really well. It's definitely I started with the Post in 2008, and I had adjusted every time to what's going on. Like, social media became really, you know, the thing that everybody wanted to do, and all the newspapers started really relying heavily on it. That's when I went to my editor and said, look, I can't keep doing these flash animations that have to go into the digital system, and then you have to have a pre-roll ad that is normally a CGM animation that nobody wants to sit through. But give me a blog, and then I can do these skits that don't have to have any ads for them. And I can put up a static thing, I can put up live sketches, I write occasionally. It gives me the freedom to use whatever medium works best for my audience. So, take the initiative. You know, if you're not happy with what you're doing, you know, wherever you're working, go, no, I can really do this. And I just had to prove it. And, you know, after a while, my editor's going, are you good? You're going to keep doing those gifts, right?
Could you please talk a little bit about how you establish yourself as a woman in editorial comics, understanding that this space is heavily male-dominated? And then noting how you really have called it out several times in your work, how the Trump administration also states that you may return to the subject and select sort of a special project.
Okay, so the first part was...
Sorry, two-prong question.
The first part was, how did I get into the... ignorant. I didn't know. No, you know, when I went into editorial cartooning, I was coming from animation, which wasn't heavily at that time a lot of women either. But I didn't know that there were hardly any women editors. so I was truthfully ignorant. I just did it. But I was also motivated. I mean, I really think, at least for me, when I'm motivated and inspired by something, that's what I'm interested in. I watched it even at home. I was a young woman that had worked in business. I had a touch of grass. I knew very well that doesn't matter. It made me angry to see all those senators up there not believe her. So I thought, let's get her portfolio and go see some of those public health. And that's how I got into it. This administration. They're, pussies, you know? I mean, the fact that no one cares. And now just recently, Trump is, he's actually defending that guy that just was on.
Two guys.
I'm talking about Ford, that was the secretary to Carol Fisher, the photograph of his first wife, black guy. And Trump is tweeting out, you know, his two sides every day. You know, and I'm just, when you get angry, that's the one in a